As part of the space program, astronauts were put under a grueling training schedule in a rushed attempt to take mankind to the moon before the end of the decade. The extenuating exercises called for the pilots to get acquainted with a flying machine like no other on Earth, one that imitated lunar conditions. During one such exercise, the legendary Neil Armstrong lost control of his vehicle and, as captured on video, barely made it out of the wreckage alive. However, as newer evidence has emerged many decades after the Apollo program initiated, the entire Apollo 11 crew almost didn't make it back from the moon. All in. The journey to the moon started long before that fateful summer of 1969. Following President John F. Kennedy's ambitious declaration that the U.S. would land a man on Earth's satellite and return him safely, a race began to achieve the gargantuan undertaking. In the years leading to the renowned Apollo 11 mission, astronauts were submitted to a rigorous training program. Some of the exercises they had to execute were just as dangerous, if not more, than the mission itself, and the path was plagued with incidents. A particular and quite dangerous exercise involved a test module known as LLRV, or Lunar Landing Research Vehicle. Despite its risky nature, the LLRV was essential for the success of the space missions. The test vehicles were nicknamed by the astronauts Flying Bedsteads, but they were of the utmost importance for a complete immersion, having been meticulously designed to replicate the gravity of the moon. Besides the landing, the astronauts also had to train on key aspects of the mission, practicing every step of the process, from how to plant the iconic American flag on the moon's surface to wilderness survival skills in case the return to Earth somehow failed. Nevertheless, piloting the lunar module was perhaps the hardest of all, and it was during one such exercise that Neil Armstrong almost lost his life. Reality meets expectations. On May 6, 1968, roughly a year before the momentous Apollo 11 liftoff, Neil Armstrong lifted the LLRV from Ellington Air Force Base in the vicinity of Houston, Texas. The expert had already done this many times before, even calling the vehicle, quote, a contrary machine and a risky machine, but a very useful one. Suddenly, the machine malfunctioned, and the test pilot lost control of the vehicle. Video taken at the scene shows the exact moment the vehicle veered violently off course and plummeted to a devastating end. However, the astronaut launched himself free a split second before the catastrophe. Fortunately, he managed to hit the ejector at 200 feet above the ground and parachuted back to safety. Despite the tension that day, the accident didn't give the astronauts, or anyone else, much of a respite. Having barely escaped from a fiery wreck, Armstrong returned to his tight schedule and performed dozens more test landings to prepare for the mission. As it turned out, the risk paid off. Over a year later, on July 20th, 1969, Armstrong and his team managed to take the spaceworthy machine to the moon's surface. The astronaut later said that, quote, the lunar module was easier to fly than the simulator, because we were expecting something that was somewhat more cantankerous and contrary than it actually turned out to be. Even so, not many people know that the team that first landed on the moon almost didn't make it back to Earth. Houston. During the historic mission, there were a handful of close calls that could have resulted in tragedy. For one, a well-shared anecdote among spaceflight enthusiasts and historians is how the alarms went off inside the spacecraft minutes ahead of the moon landing. The flight computer was unexpectedly overloaded and could have quit any second. An unforeseen crater then hindered the landing, and Armstrong and his colleague, Buzz Aldrin, were forced to spend most of their precious fuel navigating to smoother terrain. Moreover, science journalist and author Nancy Atkinson eventually unearthed another fascinating incident that was nearly erased from history. according to the author's research, there was a severe anomaly during the astronaut's re-entry to the planet, one that was classified for a long time. In fact, the situation and its potentially tragic consequences were noticed only weeks after the crew had already come back. Not even NASA was fully aware of the perils the Apollo 11 crew was in. And to make matters worse, Atkinson discovered that the same issue also endangered the crews of at least three other Apollo missions. About 15 minutes before splashdown, the spacecraft, comprising a command and a service module, separated into two parts. The command module holding the crew had a heat shield, while the storage section was jettisoned. Once the service module became useless, the parts separated. But against NASA's predictions and calculations, the service module did not drift away from the capsule, posing a collision risk. Instead, the module chased the crew along their descent. Aldrin, looking out the window, noticed the problem and reported to Mission Control, quote, "Houston, we got the service module going by. A little high and a little bit to the right." Within moments, he added, quote, "It's coming across now from right to left." Suddenly, radio communications went out. Things gone bad. The plasma buildup ahead of the capsule temporarily messed with the radio, but that was expected. However, it prevented the crew from conveying more details. Even so, neither the astronauts, mission controllers, nor the communications personnel understood there was a problem until after NASA debriefed the crew weeks later. In reality, the service module should have been nowhere close to the capsule in its descent. Had the module collided with it, it could have destroyed the vehicle or sent it circling out of control. Glimmering pieces of the disintegrating spacecraft could have also struck the capsule. In the words of NASA electrical engineer Gary Johnson, quote, "If things had gone bad, we could have lost the Apollo 11 crew. We were lucky." A thorough investigation found that two other missions, Apollo 8 and Apollo 10, also suffered the same glitch. However, the crews never sighted the service module out the window. The author confirmed that the old radar recordings showed the service modules also flew dangerously close to the crew's capsule, apparently due to a bad sequence in a controller that signaled the service module to jettison. Making matters worse, NASA was already aware of the problem by the time the Apollo 12 mission was launched, but decided to go on without fixing it due to time constraints. The Space Service kept the debriefs of the Apollo 11 crew classified for a while. The official report about the anomaly was published in late 1970, 6 months after the infamous Apollo 13 mission, but somehow managed to stay out of the news. As the author explained, quote, "The event never made it into the Apollo 11 mission reports and somehow was largely forgotten, I think due to the franticness of the time, of needing to move on to the next flight, etc. The first time the fix for this anomaly was in place was for Apollo 13. And of course, you know what happened with 13. And I think the anomaly was probably largely forgotten due to all the other excitement." As of today, Apollo 11 is hailed as an extraordinary achievement, taking the first humans to the moon and bringing them back safely, just as the president promised. Thank you for watching my video. Please like and subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified of our newest content. Also, don't hesitate to check out the rest of our Dark Documentaries channels, where we delve deep into more fascinating historical, military, and technological stories. Stay tuned.